Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Happy to Teach Tutorial. I am Bella Patel. In this module we will learn about successor and predecessor. First look at the definition of successor. Okay, a number that comes after a given number is called the successor of given number. Okay, we will understand the concept of successor by some example. Okay, on adding 1 to a given number, we get the successor of a particular number. Okay, so for finding out the successor of a given number, you have to just add to the given number, so you will get the successor of particular number. Okay, for example 7. Okay, we want to find out the successor of number 7, so we just add 1 to the 7. Okay, so we get 8. So 8 will be the successor of number 7. Okay, in second example, the given number is 49. Okay, so for finding out the successor of 49, we have to add just 1 to the 49. So we get 5050. Okay, so 5050 is the answer, successor of number 49. Okay, like that, 269 is the number. Okay, particular given number. So we want to find out the successor of 269. We have to just add to the 269. So we get 270. It will be the successor of 269. Okay, in this example the given number is 1270. So for finding out the successor of 1270, we just add 1 to the 1270, so we will get 1271. Okay, it is the successor of 1270 number. Okay, likewise, suppose given number is 1000. Okay, 1000. So for finding out the successor of 1000, we just add 1 to the 1000. Okay, so we will get 1001. Okay, so 1001, it is the successor of particular number 1000. Okay, now we will see the concept of predecessor. Okay, look at the definition of predecessor. A number that comes before a given number is called predecessor of given number. Okay, I repeat, a number that comes before a given number is called predecessor of a particular number. Let's see some example of predecessor. For finding out the predecessor of a given number, we just have to subtract 1 from a given number, so we get its predecessor. Okay, so by subtracting 1 from the given number, we get its predecessor. Okay, for example, the given number is 9. If we want to find out the predecessor of number 9, so we have to subtract 1 from a given number 9. Okay, so we will get the answer 8. So 8 is the predecessor of a given number 9. Okay, same way, suppose if we want to find out the predecessor of 6060, we have to subtract 1 from the given number 60, so we get 5959. So 59 will be the predecessor of 6060 number. Okay, if we want to find out the predecessor of 477 number, so we have to just subtract 1 from 477. Okay, so we will get 476. 476 will be the predecessor of the given number 477. Let's see another example, 1722. Okay, it is the given number. If we want to find out the predecessor of 1722, we have to just subtract 1 from 1722. So we will get 1721. Okay, so 1721 will be the predecessor of the given number 1722. Okay, same way, if we want to find out the predecessor of 2000, so we have to subtract 1 from 2000, so we will get the answer 1999. So 1099 will be the predecessor of 2000. Okay, let's see some more example of successor and predecessor together. Look at here, suppose you want to find out the successor and predecessor of given number 10. So you have to just, for finding out the successor, you have to just add plus 1 to the given number, and for finding out the predecessor, you have to just subtract 1 from the given number. Okay, so you will get successor and predecessor of given number. Okay, same way, suppose given number is 99. Okay, so if you want to find out the successor of 99, you have to just add 1 to the 99, so you will get 100. Okay, it will be the successor of 99. And if you want to find out the predecessor of 99, So you have to just subtract 1 from 99. So you will get 98 will be the predecessor of the given number 99. Okay. Same way here, 875 is the given number. For finding the successor of given number, you have to just add 1 and you will get successor. Okay. And subtract 1 from the given number, you will get predecessor. Okay. In next example, the given number is 1110. Okay. So for finding the successor of given number, you have to just add 1 to the given number and you will get the successor of a particular number. Okay. And for finding out the predecessor of given number, you have to just subtract 1 from the given number. So you will get the predecessor of a given number. Okay. Same way in next example, suppose the given number is 1511. So for finding the successor of a particular number, you have to just add 1 to the 1511. So you will get the successor of a particular number. And for finding predecessor of a particular number, you have to just subtract 1 from the given number. So you will get the predecessor of a given number. Okay. Same way here, the given number is 5000. Okay. So you want to find the successor of 5000. So you just add 1 to the 5000 and you will get the 5001 answer will be the successor of a 5000. And if you want to find the predecessor of a particular number, so you have to subtract 1 from the 5000. Okay. So you will get 4999 will be the predecessor of a given number 5000. Okay. Look at some more example of predecessor and successor. Look at this particular number. You have to find out the successor and predecessor of this particular number. Okay. Just add 1 to find out the successor of a particular number and just subtract 1 from the particular number or a given number to find out predecessor. Okay. Please go through it and clear your concept. I suggest you to do some more example for better understanding. Okay. I hope this topic is clear to you. If you have any query, then please comment me on a comment box. I will definitely give you a solution. If you like my video, then please like it, share it to your friends, and please subscribe for watching more videos. Thanks for watching. Bye. Please subscribe Happy to Teach tutorial channel for watching more videos and press the bell icons for getting notification of upcoming videos. Thank you.